Alrighty, welcome to another Dominaria Sealed here on ChannelFireball.com. Let's see what we got. Start by rarity. Phyrexian Scriptures. Ooh, you put a plus one counter on one of your creatures. Then you blow everything up but that creature, and of course, not all other artifacts. And then who cares about number three? Clifftop Retreat, sure. Ooh, Gilded Lotus, which works nicely with Josu Vess. 4 mana, 4/5 menace is very good. And an additional kicker of 6, I'm making 8/2/2 black. Zombie-like creatures with menace is also pretty nice, especially with Gilded Lotus. Oath of Teferi blinks something I control, and then I can activate Planeswalkers twice. No, this seems horrible. And Shalai, Voice of Plenty. This card's pretty good. 4 mana, 3/4 flyer, already be good, and has 2 relevant lines of text. All right, let's go by color. What do we have? Well, let's see what black has. Fungal Infection, I like that. Cabal of Angels, not very good. Cabal... or Caligo Skin Witch is very good. I think in Sealed, this card's pretty sweet. Cast Down's obviously great. This just destroys a non-legendary creature. I like Soul Salvage. This returns 2 creatures from your graveyard to your hand. Josu Vess, of course, is good. I wanted to look at black first because I have 2 black bombs, so I really want to play black. Oh, wow. Settle the Score. Exile target creatures. Just an Eviscerate, which I also have. So we're definitely playing black, 100%. Kind of like Lingering Phantom 2, but we'll see. It's a 6 mana 5/4 that when it dies, or you can bring it back when you play a historic card. Wow, double in bowls as clutches. All right, let's lay out blue. Cloud Reader Sphinx is very nice. 5 mana 3/4 Scry. Time of Ice is interesting. Taps 2 creatures, then bounces all taps creatures. I don't know that I'm actually in for that card. So it's got I like Academy Drake. 3 mana 2/2 flying. Kicker 4, get 2 counters. The first 2 syncopates are pretty good. The third one gets a little worse because you really do not want to draw multiples of them, but they are good in your hand in the first like 5 turns or so. Academy Journey Mage is good. 5 mana, 3/2 bounce. Cheaper if you have a wizard, and Caligo Skin Witch is actually a wizard. Oh, and Blink of an Eye, another really good bounce spell. So that's 18 plus Rona, which is pretty nice with all my historic cards. So that's 19. Plus Gilded Lotus certainly is 20. Gilded Lotus with all these expensive cards seems pretty nice. And I don't want Power Stone Shard, but I do like Skittering Surveyor a lot, even if you're just 2 colors, which this deck I think should be able to just be 2 colors. Guardians of Koilos, return another target historic permanent you control to its owner's hand. So it works very nicely with Phyrexian Scriptures. Pretty good with In Bolas' Clutch. It's actually not that good with Time of Ice because you tap down 2 creatures, then you play the Guardians and return Time of Ice, then those creatures just untap. Rescue, I guess I could play, but I don't really need to play Rescue. I've got Blink of an Eye. I've got other things that are doing just fine. I don't think I need to get too greedy here. So basically it comes down to, well, let's just take a quick scan through the other colors. Green is not even close to being good enough. There's not a single good green card. So you have my Sapper, it's my best green card. Or no, I guess Ancient Animus and Land of Realms. White has Shalai, Voice of Plenty. And Gideon's Reproach to deal 4. The rest of these cards are just not that impressive. Okay. And then red has a Sheevan Fire and... yeah, that's about it. Goblin Brush. Anyway, so we're definitely playing blue-black. Sort of by converting mana cost and... group things separately here so we can see what our curve looks like. Syncopate actually is, I think, a relevant proxy for a 2-drop in that if it's in your opening hand, it's going to generally be good on turns 2 and 3. It's, though it is fine later too, it's also good against cards like In Bolas' Clutches. This has got to be a wizard, right? Oh, it's Artificer. All right, so the only wizards I have are the 2 Skin Witches and 2 Journey Mages, so because this is a knight, I believe. So I'm not casting Journey Mage early that much. I'm not feeling like I need Lingering Phantom, even though I can bring it back a decent amount of the time. This is a 3 mana 2/1 with a kind of expensive ability. I could play this, let's see. Instants or sorceries. So it's a wizard, so it helps. It kind of taps for one to cast these things. I can cast Eviscerate. Settle the Score, Soul Salvage, and Syncopates, and Blink of an Eye, Cast Down. It's really not great. How good is Guardians? Can bounce Skittering Surveyor. I like that. Can bounce Josu Vess. Can bounce in Bolas as clutches if I've like take something and then later play it and bounce that back. So it's really just good at bouncing. Like it's very very good at bouncing Scriptures and okay at bouncing Skittering Surveyor. Guess it could bounce Rona, but you could also just activate Rona. I don't know. I think with the two syncopates helping, maybe I just put in the third syncopate. I'm not loving that. I could play Befuddle, but I don't think I have enough creatures to make this actually good. Rescue. I just don't like this card. It's. I don't want to maximize my deck for when I draw Scriptures because this card's really good. And I think I'll win a lot of the games when I draw Scriptures already. Rescue with these things. Yeah. Another just random. I can just play a random 5/4. I guess that's a way to finish the game. And I've got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 ways to bring it back. That's kind of a lot. Or I could just play Vodilion Arcanist and use it to cast my 4-drop removals. That's pretty bad. I could play Time of Ice. Maybe this card's good. And maybe it'll... I'm kind of curious how this plays out. I think I'm okay with playing 18 lands. I've got just a lot of mana sinks. And I have Scry card. I do like the Soul Salvage, even though I'm a little light on creatures. Actually, the Soul Salvage makes me want to play another creature. I don't really want it to be the 5, otherwise I would try Guardians of Koilos. 2 mana, 1/3, it untaps an artifact that just... I'm going to untap my Guild Lotus, I guess. Maybe I'm just supposed to play the third syncopate and just spend a bunch of my time syncopating things. Alright, I suppose I'm in for that. So let's try that. Let's add some lands. It can't be worth splashing now. I think the deck is good enough that splashing would just be a mistake. Yeah, I play 9 of each and head to the queue. Let's do this thing. Alrighty, time for round one. I would definitely like to be on the play. I'm playing 18 lands and a bunch of syncopates. Alright, I'll keep this. Actually, it's not because of this hand, though this hand would rather be on the draw too. Actually, the syncopates I think are an argument to be on the draw. There's just not that many 2-drops, and you can just counter their turn 3 play instead. So this seems... Alright, I think I might actually choose to draw after this. And Blood Tallow Candle, this is the 6 mana, give a creature minus 5, minus 5. Yeah, I don't care about that very much. I'm not going to run out the Caligo Skin Witch, I don't think. I kind of don't like the name Skin Witch. It sounds like a really disgusting sandwich. But the Brood Witch, I haven't thought about that one for a while. I just don't think this really accomplishes much in play right now. So, I'm not going to play it. I will play Josu Vess, though. And Bolas' Clutches, yeah... My deck's power level is through the roof. It even takes permanents. I can take like an Icy Manipulator. Denifa. 2/2 First Strike Vigilance Lifelink. Or an equipment cost you 2 less to cast. All right, let's just draw, because if we draw a Swamp, I'll just play Josu Vess. Of course, I drew Syncopate. So that was like the one card that would make me want to have cast... I can't even cast down, so... I wasn't going to blink of an eye at, so yeah, all is according to plan. It's okay. I can just block her with the Caligo Skin Witch, though I do want to leave up Syncopate for whatever my opponent chooses to play this turn. Amaranthine Wall? Oh no, I don't care about that at all. You can just have that. Land. Alright, let's just play a Caligo Skin Witch, I guess. And, yeah, I'm feeling fine about all this. Like, yeah, I'm a little behind, and my opponent's tapping out something big here, but as long as it's not like a Planeswalker or something, I feel like I'm in pretty decent shape. I've got Cast Down, I've got Blink of an Eye if worst comes to worst. At some point I'll get to cast In Bolas' Clutches and steal something. And... Eviscerate my Caligo Skin Witch. I did not anticipate that being the play. Alright, I guess I'm glad I didn't draw the land to cast Josu Vess. Am I going to have to discard the hand size here? I just don't think I'm supposed to play anything. What am I supposed to do here? I think I'm discard Academy Journey Mage because I can just cast Soul Salvage to get those two things back. Take my two. I'm not taking that much damage. Like, this is fine, but this is discard a hand size on turn five or whatever. This is pretty bad. All right. I can syncopate this. It costs one more. Cabal Paladin. Yeah, we're gonna syncopate you. We're just running out of opportunities to cast syncopate, so we'll do that. And it's exiled. And I drew a swamp. Okay. Yeah, let's cast Juzu Fess. I know my opponent can Blood Tallow Candle it, but it takes up their turn, and then I can Soul Salvage back. Probably Josu and the Caligo Skin Witch. We'll see what I draw. Unless I'm just getting eviscerated again. Oh, they exiled it? Never to return? All right. Oh, Gilded Lotus. Wow, that is. All right. Gilded Lotus makes me want to just say go because I can just keep Blink of an Eye up and then. And draw a card, and then next turn, land Gilded Lotus, Soul Salvage back my two wizards. And then once I get the Gilded Lotus going, we're really talking. Oh, please let this be like some aura on. Oh, Dark Bargain? Well, I can't stop that. So my opponent mulliganed and played an Amaranthine Wall, which is, I think, not going to impact the outcome of the game significantly, though I guess it does. Not die to Phyrexian Scriptures. But they're getting back into it with Dark Bargain and the fact that I had to discard a card to hand size. That's like me mulliganing. So that's not particularly great. Let's see, they did not want Phyrexian Scriptures of their own. I guess I'm just not playing a single creature. That makes sense. All right, I'm gonna blink of an eye because I want to cast this anyway. No reason to take damage. In Bolas's Clutches. That's not a land. Land? Come on. And if I cast Soul Salvage, I'm gonna have to discard. So I'm probably not gonna do that. I think I just say go. Like, what am I supposed to do here? Like, if I cast a Skin Witch, it doesn't have anything to block. If I cast Phyrexian Scriptures, my opponent will just not play a creature for a turn. What is this? Hopefully this isn't legendary. Oh. Yeah, that is annoying. Discard a Caligo Skin Witch and cast down? Clutches? Scriptures? Kind of think it's scriptures? That's so bizarre. No, I'm just gonna discard cast down. All right, I would really like to draw land here so I can go Lotus into Soul Salvage. Would be helpful. And all right, hopefully I don't get hit by another Caligo Skin Witch. That would be really annoying. All right, I'm gonna definitely get back a Skin Witch, and I think I get back the Journey Mage as well. Though if I get back two Skin Witches. No, that actually seems great. Let's just get back two Caligo Skin Witches. And then I get to that the combination of Skin Witch and Phyrexian Scriptures is nice, where I get to force them to play out all their creatures, and then I get to kill all non-artifact creatures. So it is pretty good. And see what their play is. They haven't played a land in a while, so they have a lot of gas in hand, which is why I kind of wanted these Skin Witches. So we're splashing green, it would appear. I'm not sure for what yet. What you got? See, here they don't need to hit me first. I'm tapped out. They can just play their spell first. But I guess it is technically correct to attack before playing spells in most of the time. So it's probably better than Deny fat. Sure. Get four cards. I'm at 11. All right. I'm going to play my land. I just don't think I'm getting... If they had another way to make me discard, they'd use it. And now I might be in a spot where I want to next turn play a kicked Skin Witch and then play Scriptures. They also might have been holding lands because they saw me bring back the two Skin Witches, so could be a way to protect their things. They discarded Denitha and Icy Manipulator? It's so confusing that their best play was a Stronghold Confessor and they discarded Icy to Skin Witch. What's going on with that? I'm going to go to 8 here. If they play something too threatening, then I might have to cast in Bolas's Clutches. How about my Sap Herd? That's not too threatening. All right, we're going to play another Skin Witch, and then we're going to play Scriptures, and it's kind of like we all drew it up. They have no cards in hand? What did they keep instead of Icy? Oh, Grun the Lonely King. So they're not splashing me, and they're just playing all the colors. Painting with all the colors of the wind. All right. Well, I'm not going to get to keep my Skin Witch necessarily because they have a Blood Tallow Candle, but that's all right. Basically, after all is said and done, I'm going to be at, like, 5 or 4 life. But my opponent's going to have no creatures except an Amaranthine Wall in play. I guess they don't want to necessarily use the candle. I don't know. And I'm going to have 2 control magics in my hand. So, or confiscate, actually. So I'm feeling pretty good about this. What maximizes... I guess this is... This is fine for taking less damage. Because I can double block the 3 thing, or I can block that. Ooh, I actually don't hate Syncopate here. The Scriptures, as has been foretold. All right, and then I get to pass with 9 mana up. And double Bolas's Clutches. And a Syncopate. They did not want to use the candle. What you got? If it's good, I'm going to steal it. But I also might counter it. We'll see. Never mind. No, it's happening. Stronghold Confessor. Yeah, I'm fine stealing that thing. They have no cards in hand. I can still Syncopate for 2, and then I also have a second in Bolas's Clutches. All right. Scriptures goes away, and then we steal the Stronghold Confessor. And pass the turn. With Syncopate for 4 up, so they can resolve a 3-drop at most. And again, I have another control magic here. I guess I'm not actually getting damage through because they can Blood Tallow Candle the Stronghold Confessor. But, hey, at least we force them to do so. Ooh, Academy Drake? Yeah, I'll cast that. Yeah. That is a fine play. Then I'll cast this with Kicker. Can still Syncopate for 3. This wall does not have flying. If they play something that's really good, I can just steal it, like this thing. 4/4 Vigilance makes knights. Wow, and it's a knight, I'm sure. Yeah, so that's a good card for me to steal. I'll play my land because I want to keep up Syncopate. We are getting to the point where I'm running out of answers, but... I even have a Guild Lotus, so I can activate the white ability. I get to Syncopate this turn for 5, so they can resolve a 3-drop. Okay. And they just snap-played their land. All right. I think we're in the home stretches here. Ooh, Rona, Disciple of Gix. Okay, let's see. I've got a legendary card I can exile in Bolas's Clutches. This deck is gross. Yeah, we'll use that ability. I could actually cast this right now. I'm not going to, but I could. Wow. Yeah, Guild Lotus is great in this deck. I think Guild Lotus is very good here. Not every limited deck's going to want Gilded Lotus, but ones with very powerful high-end certainly do. No cards in hand. I have Syncopate for 8 up, so they can't cast anything. All right. Definitely want to be on the draw after playing all that. That in my deck seems perfect. All right, that's cool. Don't think I want Guardians of Koilos. Yeah, Lingering Phantom, nah. This all seemed fine to me. Alrighty, time for game 2. Alright, I'm going to run this hand because I don't like mulliganing. This hand's a little flooded, I'm not going to lie. So this makes a look at the top 5 and put a creature. Yeah. Ooh, Rona's not bad. She's not exactly a turn 3 play, but she still is a way to impact the board. And then if I can like trade off for Chump with Skittering Surveyor and play Rona on Skittering Surveyor, that's already pretty good. Ooh, Cloud Reader Sphinx. That's a good one. All right, let's get Surveyor. And we will not be missing land drops this game, I'll tell you that much. Also feels really good to be playing just 2 colors. I think if you can end up playing 2 colors in Sealed, you're pretty happy. If my opponent's expecting me to play a card that's good against that they can use a removal spell on. 3-3 Menace. I don't really like that. Ooh, Syncopate. All right, I would have liked to draw that earlier, but this is fine. I'm going to send with this because I'm going to be able to run it at some point here. Yeah, so what I'm going to plan on doing is turn 6 I can go. Ideally, this is all, you know, in the sky, but I syncopate this turn. Next turn I play Cloud Reader. Turn 6 I go Rona and immediately play Skittering Surveyor. I take a little bit of damage from Stronghold Confessor while this is all occurring. Yeah, we are syncopating you. Just like last game. But I think we're doing okay. And then Rona plus Skittering Surveyor can maybe block the Confessor. Oh, Gilded Lotus. Okay, I like Gilded Lotus, but I think I'd still rather play the Sphinx, though Gilded Lotus could change how things operate over the next turn or two. Caligo Skin Witch. I don't want Fungal Infection. I do want the Skin Witch, though. Alright, so what we're going to do now is go kicked Skin Witch on turn 6, and then we'll see what we do after that. Fortunately, I do get a 14... The Skin Witch also lets me double block the Confessor. Hopefully my opponent doesn't play like Grunt or something. Oh, Cabal Paladin, sure. Alright, you're going to go to one card in your hand. And we're definitely leaving the Cloud Reader Sphinx back. If it gets eviscerated, I could take a little bit of damage here. Caligo Skin Witch is a fairly powerful card. It also gets around Shalai. Even if your opponent has Hexproof, this just says each opponent. It's kind of funny. Let's see what my opponent's got. Last game they discarded incredibly good cards, but I'm not sure exactly why. This game they discarded Fungal Infection, which I don't care about, and Blessed Light. I don't like that. Given that they discarded Blessed Light, I feel like either my Sphinx isn't long for this world, or they're going to play something really powerful. But they could have played something last turn that was good, and they just played the Cabal Paladin, which is just fine. Okay, so they just had Eviscerate. Better? Oh, I'd rather them do that than kill it otherwise. All right, let's just chump. Go to 11. Land. I think we actually have to Rona here and not... I don't think I have time to cast Gilded Lotus. So get the Surveyor out of here. Did they draw a Vicious Offering? Are they going to kill it in response? That would be annoying. Alright, they did not, so then we just get to play it. And then now we've got either a trade for the Cabal Paladin or a double block on the Stronghold Confessor. So we'll see. We'll see what we do here. Uh-oh, I don't like this. My game plan was kind of predicated on them not having two follow-up removal spells. I was ready to beat one. Ooh, okay. I think I'm supposed to just trade here. That card is just dangerous to have a Cabal Paladin in play. Oh no. Oof, really punished for not double blocking. Okay. So, I guess I can get back this Cloud Reader Sphinx and Rona and then play Cloud Reader Sphinx. And that's my game plan here. And then I can look for In Bolas' Clutches. I like both of these things. So 9 mana next turn. Yeah. Let's draw a cast down first. Okay. It's going to be close here, but I actually think we're going to be fine. And if my opponent can kill my Sphinx, then that's unfortunate, but again, still not dead. And if they can't kill Sphinx, then they can send both in. Dark Bargain. Okay, that's not bad. So if they can't kill Sphinx, they send both in, and I probably just double block the Confessor. No, I just blocked the Cabal Paladin with the Cloud Reader Sphinx. So they chose not to keep the Blood Liturgist. They chose to keep a land, or they probably already had a land. They have like a Vicious Offering or something? Well, if they do, it's not actually that bad for me. Here I actually think I do double block in case they have -1/-1 or +1/+1. Alright, so I take 4, go to 3, but I have cast out on top of my deck. If I need it. Can't kill this, but again, still not dead, so I have 8-9 mana. I can play a kicked Academy Drake. And then leave up cast down. I am gonna start losing to that Slimefoot though. I'm at 3, and my opponent can make a bunch of slime balls. What they might do though is they might attack with both, because right now I'm forced to double block Stronghold Confessor and fall to 1 off Slimefoot. That's a forced play, except they don't know that I have cast down in hand. So if they do that, then I get to just block Slimefoot with Academy Drake and then cast down the Stronghold Confessor. So let's see what my opponent does here. I actually don't think it's wrong for them to attack with both. Attack with neither? Well, that just can't be right. I'm drawing a bounce spell. I guess I do cast down this. Since Slimefoot's legendary, I don't really have a choice there. And I don't have any legendary creatures. So let's see. 9 mana. I could go Journey Mage the Slimefoot. And then play Rona. I think that's my plan. Yeah, they get to make 2 tokens. Actually, they made tokens in response. It's actually better to bounce a token, right? That buys me more time. And then play Disciple, which doesn't do a whole lot. And hit with the Academy Drake. And basically I need to draw... I have 1 draw step. Yeah. I have 1 draw step to draw In Bolas' Clutches, or if I draw a land and I use Rona, I could exile In Bolas' Clutches. I guess I have another Academy Journey Mage. Does that buy me a turn? I don't know. Deathbloom Thalager. Well, oh, Phyrexian Scriptures. Okay, so I have a turn. If I can just In Bolas' Clutches that would be clutch. Right now, all right. I drew a land, so at least I have another out. Whoa, bam. You can't cast it. Do I die here? Technically not, but my opponent... Well, my opponent can make me die here. We'll see if they figure it out. Basically, what they can do is upkeep, make two saplings with slime foot, and then Phyrexian Scriptures will blow them all up, and I'll die. They got there. Okay. Time for game three. I'm definitely gonna be on the draw. I took a lot of damage off their stupid 3-3 menace, and they have like the 4-2 knights and stuff. Fungal infection was not looking great there. This actually does help block the 3-3 menace. So maybe that's fine. Befuddle. They have their own Phyrexian scriptures, which I guess I could put in like a Guardians or something. Yeah, Guardians are cool. This actually doesn't just sound bad in general. And maybe I do take out the fungal infection, though. I guess fungal infection plus skin, which is some nice blocking action. I actually might take out an Academy Journey Mage. Just didn't seem... No, that's good against them, too. This is fine. We'll be fine. I would not like to play first. Yeah, this hand's good. And... get to play... Syncopate on their three, and then just run an Academy Drake, who knows. Kick a blink of an eye, and then work up to Involus' clutches. This is the game where my opponent has like one drop into two drop or something. Island would not be bad draws. Yeah, there's an island. Skitter and Surveyor is always a good draw too. Okay, so the going second with Syncopate plan has appeared to be working so far. Alright, drawing two land in a row is good. Now, let us not draw land for a bit. And put a rock in the three colors. Yavimai Sapper, no way I'm letting that resolve. Syncopate you. If I draw another Syncopate, I probably don't play Academy Drake, but I'm certainly going to run out Drake if I don't draw a play. Oh, there's a Syncopate. All right. Yeah, I'll just wait. If I can wait a turn or two and then play Academy Drake as a 4-4, it's just much more effective. Yeah. Syncopate you. My opponent's probably very annoyed by this. Now do I just run out Drake? Yeah, let's just play the Drake. I've got plenty of action here. And if they resolve something, I get to blink of an eye or eviscerate it and lead into clutches. Clutches of Bolas. Windgris Acolyte. They mill themselves for three. Land. I'm just gonna pass. Like, Academy Drake trades for Windgrace Acolyte, and there's really no reason to use a removal spell on it. And if they have a combat trick, I have Blink of an Eye, and that works out really well for me. Alright. I'm fine with this trade. If my opponent wants to play something here, are they running scared? Are they worried about the third Syncopate? I actually do have three Syncopates, though. They should not play around the third Syncopate. Slimefoot. My old friend. I don't think I want to bounce Slimefoot here. I think I'd rather just cast Clutches. Actually, you know what? I'm just going to eviscerate my old buddy Slimefoot. I feel like I can clutch something a little better, and I'm kind of feeling like I'm getting set up here with a Blessed Light. So maybe if I wait, I can clutches with Blink of an Eye up, because you can bounce your own clutches in response to something. I should probably keep the Swamp in hand. Caligo Skin Witch is really annoying. Grun the Lonely King. Well, that's something I am going to clutch. They have one card in hand. If they had Caligo Skin Witch, they would have played it. So I'm just going to play the Gilded Lotus. Actually, I'm just going to... No, there's no protection giving. I'm just going to pass. Yeah, this works fine. And then I'm going to Blink of an Eye the Grun. And then play Clutches later. I don't know, maybe I'll draw a Syncopate or something, or a Skin Witch, or some way to empty my opponent's hand before I play Clutches. I think I will end up playing Clutches at this point. They have one card in hand that is not Grun. And if I get hit by the Skin Witch, that's why I didn't play my Swamp, I'll discard Cloud Reader Sphinx and the Swamp. Right, Grun. Of course, it is unfortunate that I can't play the Cloud Reader Sphinx now this turn, because I didn't play a land last turn, but I'm not gonna play it now. Alright. Do they have it? They have it. Oh, they have Dark Bargain? Okay, they might have it after this, but... Unless... And it has to be almost exactly Blessed Light, because if they have, like, Eviscerate to kill Grun, that is more than fine. I really just want them not to kill in Bolas's Clutches. I'm gonna wait. Alright, I'll attack. No. They let me untap and maybe draw a counterspell. I did not. Good thing is that does not have trample. Whoa, what are we doing here? Let's play the Surveyor first. So I have a little time here to find another Bolas's Clutches, or Josu would also be really good. I have another bottom up, a Journey Mage on top. Journey Mage has to be good enough here. Blood Tallow Candle, so they can kill my Sphinx. I'm gonna chump with the Surveyor. And so I get to Journey Mage, bounce Grun, so I have a couple turns of reprieve. And I have enough mana that I could kick Josu Vest, so I don't really want to play lands again because of the Skin Witch. They have one card in hand that isn't Grun. We've been here before, though. Let's see what they've got. What? Oh, no, there's Kick and Grun. It's a 2020 now. Sure. I guess that I didn't consider that, but that works. All right, let's get back Cloud Reader Sphinx Academy Drake. And then play the Sphinx. And see what I can dig up here. Well, at this point, I don't want Syncopate. I do want Josu Vest, though. Play land, play Academy Drake. All right. I feel like I'm in a really good spot now. I mean, the Lonely King is going to go ape here and just attack for 20, but I think I can beat a 2020. I mean, I think I can easily beat a 2020. I have an Army of the Damned on my side. Oh, man. I needed to not have Phyrexian Scriptures. That would have gotten me good. It's kind of funny how Scriptures plays against each other, too. All right. Humph. And now my opponent, I assume, is, like, extremely dead. I mean, because even a Phyrexian Scriptures... I block with one of my zombie knights on Grun this turn. They needed like a sweeper of some kind that doesn't have a one turn delay. Oh, they drew the Scriptures a turn too late. Because yeah, I'm just attacking for lethal now. Ha! I wonder if they had it last turn. That would be really funny. Let's see, because now they're going to attack for 22. Now they're not even going to attack. But unfortunately for them, this is a... just playing this for value. This was a pretty epic battle here. I can't think of a fog or anything like that, so I'm just going to attack with everything. That's how this ends. Because at this point, they can't actually even block a single one of my creatures. So they would need a literal fog. And I don't even think there is one. All right, we're getting in there. The Lonely King, living up to his name, sitting there lonely, watching an army march past him. Whew. Close match. Wow. That was a good first match. Let's see how the other ones do. Alrighty, time for round two. That was a pretty epic match. I'm going to go ahead and keep this hand. It's got a turn three Drake. It's got a Bolas's Clutches. Ooh, it's got a turn four Josu Vess. This card is really good in this deck. Guild Lotus. Lands are fine draws. This deck is really good. I assume this is the best sealed deck I'm going to open in this format, which both speaks to how good this deck is and how unlucky I am. Oh, look, I just drew a Phyrexian Scriptures. So now I get to play Drake, play Josu Vess, maybe play Scriptures once my opponent's played a couple creatures. Baloth Gorger. I have my own Baloth Gorger. He's a zombie Lich Death Knight. This is just a 4/4. Also with Soul Salvage in hand, I'm just like snap blocking if my opponent attacks. I might just get eviscerated though. Mammoth Spider. Okay, so now we just Scriptures up Josu Vess and pass the turn. And basically this means that my opponent can't play a creature on their turn. In other words, it's just going to die to Phyrexian Scriptures. And I get to trade Drake and Scriptures for their 4-drop and their 5-drop, which is a pretty solid, I think, tempo gain. Plus, I have Soul Salvage, and I have Inbolus's Clutches. The way this goes kind of wrong is if they kill Josu Vess with, like, an Eviscerate, but if they don't have it, then this works out pretty nicely. All right, they don't. And I'm not going to use the Soul Salvage, because just getting back a lone Drake seems not needed. And now my opponent taps out for a creature, and I cast Inbolus's Clutches. In conclusion, I beat my opponent with a bunch of legendary rares, mythics, and I guess this is a legendary uncommon, but Slimefoot, I've seen that guy before. Get out of here, your graveyard. I am going to attack because my opponent can't block, and I think I still do steal the Slimefoot. Yeah, it still has menace is the thing. Yeah, we're going to get an illegal blocking. Josu Vess Lich Knight can't be blocked except by two or more creatures. Probably one are assigned to block it. Get over here, Slimefoot. I've also drawn all lands, which is more than fine, because if Josu Vess dies, I get to Soul Salvage. Hey, I played my stupid rares. I didn't see enough to make me want to change my sideboard, so here we go. Alrighty, time for game two. I am going to keep this hand because I have Skittering Surveyor, which can go find me an island, which can let me cast all my blue spells. Granted, if I don't draw anything, then I suppose I might lose, but yeah, there we go. I'm not in the business of mulliganing two land hands on the draw that have a colorless 3-drop that fixes my mana. Wow, my opponent is not punishing me for my slow start, which has generally been my experience in Sealed. And I get to... Can't Journey Mage next turn. I'm probably just going to leave up Syncopate. Yeah, they'll play like a Baloth Gorger, and that's fine. I'm just going to pass, leave up Syncopate. Take four. I don't really see a reason to chump here. And then I'll Syncopate whatever they play this turn, assuming they tap out for something. Then I can Journey Mage the Baloth Gorger next turn. Yeah. Oop, get out of here. Exiled too. I think Journey, and it's not gonna get any cheaper, so it's not like I'm getting value out of the Wizards getting cheaper part. I just don't see a reason to play Cloud Reader Sphinx and then just take four on the crackback, rather than play Journey Mage, pick nothing, they play the Baloth or something else, and then I play my Cloud Reader Sphinx, and I can double block with Journey Mage plus Skittering Surveyor. Ooh. That's actually really interesting. Let's see what I scry into. I don't want Swamp, and I do want in Bolas's Clutches. So, I was going to block with the 3-2 and the 1-2, which just straight up trade for the Baloth. They have the Piercing Winds or whatever. They're going to kill my Cloud Reader Sphinx. Yeah, pierce the sky. Alright, I was thinking about whether I should block with the 3-4 and use -1/-1, but I don't think I was going to do that anyway. I think I am going to just double block here. If they have a trick, I lose my, you know, two creatures, which I was willing to trade off. And some of the tricks are +1/+1, in which case Fungal Infection gets me out of it. Okay. So I'm drawing in Bolas' Clutches. I got a Swamp. Let's see what they have. Deathplume Phalanx. Two cards in hand? Alright. Let's just take the Baloth Gorger. I feel like, given my hand, I can do this, and then this makes it so the board is well in my favor, and then I can bounce if they want to play something and then try to finish the game with like the Academy Drake. My other option was to just pass. It didn't seem great. Oh, if they're sacking Memorial, I feel like I'm in really good shape. This match may not be quite as difficult as the other. Thorn Elemental. Well, that's not going to resolve, but wow, that is big. And a Cabal Paladin, huh? Oh, they have two cards in hand? Oof. Caligo Skin Witch. Oof. God, this deck just really has it all, doesn't it? I guess I could use, like, one more cheap card. But still, this deck is nice. And I got their Ancient Animus. Don't think I'm supposed to attack here. I'm just going to try to finish the game with Academy Drake. And at some point, I'll have Syncopate Protection. Windgrace Acolyte. Okay. Land, now I can play a Kicked Drake. Pass the turn. Like, I could attack with the 3-2, but it trades for their 3-2 and they make a token. I could attack with my 4-4. Yeah, they're just off it. That match took like a fifth of the time of the other match, but we've got another one, so let's head in. Alrighty, time for round 3. 2-0 so far, and I'm gonna have to mulligan this, unfortunately. The one land Skittering Surveyor hand I'm less inclined to keep, though I do like the spells in my hand, but when you have 6 spells in your hand, you usually tend to accumulate a couple of good ones. So, yeah, we're not going to be keeping this hand, unfortunately. Mulligan, and oof, I think I have to mulligan this too. It's another one lander, but no cheap plays in sight. Alright, well, this is a good, I'll keep that. This is a very good 5-card hand because it has a Wrath, a removal spell, and a way to get another land. Which, conveniently enough, is an artifact. So if I can slow roll the Scriptures and put the counter on one of my other artifact or other creatures, turn it into an artifact, I'll have multiple creatures survive the Phyrexian Plague. Though, oh man, I was going to say, getting some 2-drops already. I'm not going to play the Skin, which it doesn't do anything. This is unfortunate. It's going to be hard to beat that in a long game, though I could perhaps take it with Binbolas' Clutches. They played 2 cards that don't die to Phyrexian Scriptures. I mulled a 5 and was banking on that Scripture. Alright, well, let's go get an island. Pass the turn. I could block here. It does force my opponent to have a bunch of mana, but I don't see a reason to run that quite yet. I might do that next turn. Let's see. Bloodstone Goblin, okay. Land. I'm at 18, I can take a little bit of damage. I basically would like my opponent to play like one more creature and then I'm going to play Scriptures. And I know it doesn't kill a Drudge Sentinel, but it does tap them down at least for a turn. And it wastes their turn. the turn prior, where they can't cast anything into the scriptures. Alright, Kelden Raider. Alright, that's good. And they are going to discard Yawgmoth's Vile Offering, which does is a, something they can exile to that thing. Wow, alright. Well, now I definitely have to play the scriptures. The cool thing about this is I get to force them to not play anything for a turn, and they might just play a land and say go, and then Caligo Skinwitch can go get them. The Urza's Tome does make that a little bit less good. I really needed that tome to, I guess, not be that. Let's block the Bloodstone. No, actually, we'll block the Dredge Sentinel, because the Bloodstone Goblin's dying anyway. This way, they have to regenerate this and then do it again, and then I get their last two cards with the Skinwitch. Yeah. This works out nicely. Kind of coming back from this Mold of Five, I think. Are they going to Indestructible their Dredge Sentinel? They did not. I feel like I kind of got them there. Yeah, let's Skinwitch them now. I know they get to draw a card off the Urza's Tome, but this still is kind of nice. It is also kind of cool to get to exile their graveyard here with Phyrexian Scriptures next turn. And because I have settled the score, whatever their last card is, I keep. They discard Sheevan Fire and Rampaging Cyclops. I get to go Gilded Lotus, settle the score. I don't hate how this is going. And Urza's Tome is nice, but if they don't have any historic cards to exile, it is at that point not quite as effective. Feral Abomination, okay. So I think I'm going to do is not even play the Gilded Lotus. I'm just going to settle the score on the Abomination and then leave up Syncopate for 2, which can nab like a 5-drop or something like that, or a 6-drop. And if they don't have anything, then next turn I can leave up Syncopate again. Ooh, Runa Disciple. Ooh, that lets me exile the scriptures. Actually, I'm going to kind of slow roll that because I want to play it in the same turn. Ooh, what is this? Garna. All right, we're going to syncopate Garna. Kind of wish I played Gilded Lotus first. All right. And it's exiled, so they don't get to Urza's Tome it. Actually, am I supposed to play Runa here? They don't have a removal spell right now, so I'm just going to play Runa. And that way, if they play a creature, I can then just play the scriptures. Runa's pretty powerful. And if they don't play a creature, I get to attack them for more damage. Wow. Mold of Five are kind of running over our opponent. Well, running over is not the right way to describe things. They are the one who played a bunch of stuff. Gitu Journey Mage. Okay. 3-2. Would ping me for 2 if they had another wizard. That's fine. Let's go Gilded Lotus. And cast Phyrexian Scriptures here. And I'm going to put a counter on Runa. And then I'm going to pass the turn. And then this is going to, they can loot with their Urza's Tome, but if they play anything next turn, then they get it blown up by Phyrexian Scriptures. And if they don't, so if they attack with Journey Mage, I just block with the Skin Witch. Oh, their own Phyrexian Scriptures. So I guess that just blows up my Skin Witch. Okay. They have Scriptures and Yawgmoth's Vile Offering. That's not bad, not bad. I guess they don't really have, there's no point in attacking here, because my Skin Witch is dying anyway. Actually, if they attack here, I'm double blocking. Oh, okay, well, I'm going to eviscerate that thing. And I think I'm supposed to just, they have no cards in hand. Yeah, I'm just going to attack. I'm not going to use Runa to exile a card or anything like that. They should use Urza's Tome here, I think. Because they could have just milled themselves for one, but with Urza's Tome around, I think that is actually good. Seven mana. They have a lot of mana, so a lot of stuff they could potentially play, but next turn, Scripture is going to exile my graveyard, which doesn't do anything, and I'm hoping to draw Josu Vest. That would be a nice one. Ooh, what is this? Chainer's Torment. So it drains me for two? Okay, that's not too worrisome. And oh, wow. Syncopate was a really good draw. That actually doesn't quite lock it up because I'm getting drained for two more, but Syncopate was good because now all my graveyard goes away. They drain me for two again. I go to four. They go to six, so I'm attacking them down to one. But I get to counter this, whatever they play this turn, and then we're countering that for a million. So this half life throw rounded up. Actually, no, they do die. They die to Chainer's Torment. Ha! That's amazing. That is actually very satisfying. So I attack them down to one, and then Chainer's Torment finishes them off, and they get a, because they get a 1/1 nightmare that deals them one. Wonderful. I thought this card wasn't great, and it has so far lived up to my expectations. Do I get to even see the nightmare? I do. That's like a nightmare horror noise. Black, red, Scriptures, Yawgmoth's Vile Offering. Definitely want all the Syncopates. And the Caligo Skin, which is Fungal Infection. Actually doesn't look as good here as Guardians of Coilus. The Fungal Infection does kill their 2/1 Indestructible. And it trades for a Bloodstone Goblin. This card is actually just too good to cut, isn't it? Lingering Phantom might have a place, though. Except all my cards are great. Maybe on the draw I can go to 17 land because I do have a Skittering Survivor. Suppose I can buy that. I suppose I can buy taking out a land for a 6 drop. Alrighty. Game 2. I'm going to keep this hand. It's a little sketchy. Fungal Infection does a lot for me. Also, knowing that my opponent's deck isn't super fast, I didn't really want to draw on Bolas's Clutches. If I draw that Lingering Phantom instead of a land here, I'm going to lose my mind. They don't have anything. Alright, land is good. If I could just rattle off a bunch of lands, then I'm in great shape. Also, Skittering Surveyor counts as land at this point. In fact, I'd rather draw Skittering Surveyor than most things. See, Gitu Journey Mage. That actually does get answered by Fungal Infection. Yeah, I'm supposed to cast the Caligo Skin, which for sure. Because I've got Academy Journey Mage, and now the Journey Mage is castable on 4. I think if my opponent attacks, I'm going to go for it. I'm going to block and Fungal Infection their Journey Mage. I haven't seen removal that really blows me out here. It has to be like Wizard's Lightning. Let's hope they don't have it. And yeah, if they do, it's bad. But Sheevan Breath doesn't do it. Oh. Yeah, Sheevan Fire, in fact, is just good. I would basically choose for that to happen. So yeah, that worked out. Soul Salvage isn't horrible. I'm not going to play it here because I don't need my Caligo Skin Witch back that bad. Also, my opponent's on Mono Mountains over there, by the way. So they also kept a hand that doesn't necessarily do that much. Yeah, there's no reason for me to cast Soul Salvage here. Aether Glider? Okay. Oh, there's that fifth land. Now we're really doing it. I think I'm supposed to just Cloud Reader Sphinx here. Scry. Oh, I don't want the swamp. I do want Josu Vest, though. I guess the swamp could get me closer to kicking the Guildless, but I don't think that makes me all that interested. Opponent's just dead now. And let's just play Josu Vest. With Soul Salvage in hand especially, I don't see any reason to save it. Also, my opponent's mana screwed, so let's just try to get this over with before they can cast their Phyrexian Scriptures or Yawgmoth's Vile Offering. They have some powerful cards in their deck. Wouldn't hate drawing a syncopate either. I guess they have a lot of mana. They just didn't have the right kind, so maybe syncopate wouldn't be great. Eviscerate my Josuves? Or cast Fiery Intervention? Oh, Windgrace Acolyte. No, that is definitely not going to do it. Well, there goes the Ryogmoth's Vial Offering. There goes that syncopate. Well, I'm just going to bounce the Acolyte and get in there. And so I'm attacking for 8, so... Yeah, Yawgmoth's, or Phyrexian Scriptures will just no longer do it. So, I think my opponent's dead, and I think we are advancing to 3-0. Let's see what they can muster up, but Gilded Lotus plus Syncopate is also a nice little turn, but that'll do it. All right, we are 3-0, and that will do it for this video. Just assume I 5-0'd and trophied because this deck is just busted. but I will be back with more videos, more drafts, more of everything else. And thanks for watching. See everyone later.